Hey guys, Rusty here at BLUART Robotics with an exciting new product, the Ping Sonar. The Ping Sonar is a single beam Echosounder and altimeter. At the simplest, that means it sends out an acoustic pulse and listens back for echoes to return. With that data, it provides a distance measurement to the strongest echo, as well as the full echo response, which can be plotted like the display of a fish finder sonar. Before I go into details, here's a quick demo of the Ping in action on the BLUART RV2. Here you can see an echo response while the ROV is moving up and down in a steel dive tank. The Ping has a bottom finding algorithm that locks onto the strongest response and provides a measured distance and confidence. The Ping works great as an altimeter on the BLUART RV2. But can be used in a wide variety of other applications, from obstacle avoidance to tidal monitoring to autonomous terrain following. I'll go into some more details, starting with the hardware. The Ping has an anodized aluminum case with a sonar transducer on one side. On the other side are four tapped holes, and the Ping comes with a mounting bracket that makes it easy to install on the BLUART RV2 and in other applications. The Ping comes with a 1 meter cable with a pre-installed cable penetrator and is rated to an operating depth of 300 meters. The sonar transducer operates at a frequency of 115 kilohertz, away from the frequencies typically used by boat echo sounders to minimize interference. It has a measurement range of 30 meters and a beam width of about 30 degrees. The Ping uses 5-volt power and communicates through a serial port interface. You can connect it directly to microcontroller devices like an Arduino, as well as a computer through a USB to serial adapter. To help make that as easy as possible, we're also launching a compact USB to serial and RS485 adapter today. This board has a micro USB port on one end and can connect to standard TTL serial devices like the Ping, as well as RS485 devices, which includes many subsea sensors and tools. Devices like the Ping connect through a JST-GH connector on the end, but the board also has through holes for standard header pin connections. Once you've got the Ping connected to your device or computer, there are a few ways to use it. We recommend getting started with Ping Viewer, a new open source application that we've built from the ground up to support the Ping. Ping Viewer runs on Windows, Mac, and Linux, and makes it easy to get connected to the Ping, view and record data, and change settings. Ping Viewer supports direct connections to the Ping, but also supports network connections through the BLUART RV2's companion web interface, so that you can connect to the Ping onboard the ROV without using any extra wires in the tether. The Ping communicates with Ping Protocol, a simple and open source binary protocol that transmits data messages efficiently. We have Arduino and Python libraries for Ping Protocol available, as well as example code that makes it easy to get connected. Using the Arduino library, one of our engineers, Brian, built a makeshift tidal monitor. In addition to the Ping, it uses one of our 3-inch enclosures, a battery, pressure sensor, and Arduino with a data logging shield. We deployed it on the ocean floor with the Ping pointed up to measure the distance to the water surface. We recovered it with the ROV and gripper a few days later after it had logged several thousand data samples. Here you can see the result, with the Ping's measurements showing the tidal levels throughout the day. At a higher frequency, you can see the amplitude of swells passing by the tidal monitor and how they change from day to day. With the launch of Ping and Ping Viewer, we're trying something new by launching them in beta, meaning that they're well-tested and we're confident in them, but we expect there to be a lot of changes in software, firmware, and features in the near future. We've tested in ways that are accessible to us, but we're eager to incorporate feedback from you about what can still be improved. Both the Ping and the USB to serial adapter are available on our store today, and the Ping Viewer application can be downloaded from the product pages and from GitHub. That's all I've got for today. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.